health-related issues and illnesses in the world today. I myself was in a very bad place, 353 pounds at one time, and I was smoking three packs of cigarettes a day, and I had been let go from a very wonderful job that I loved doing, and I was lost and I didn't know where I was going to go or what I was going to do. And then, as Shannon alluded to, had a wonderful person introduce me to Arbonne, and started looking at myself and the outside. And then one day, when I met Shannon, I started looking at the inside and what I needed to do to change the inside. And it's been a really crummy journey for me for the last 2 years, honestly. Inside my house, I was very isolated. And what kept me going was going out to a cooking class every day. Because I enjoyed the cooking classes. I had removed myself from everything that was important to me, and Epicure and the family that you and my team created brought me back out again. And in the last 3 months, I've just blossomed. And my team, I'm really happy, is made up a lot of really important people in my life who've come back. And now I get to share my job and also spend time with the people I really care about. So I thank you guys. Okay, that's my little blurb, Epicure and me. So back to Epi. Epi, I brought you a little token of my appreciation tonight. We are heading into Cinco de Mayo. So I'd like you to have this little package from me. It's gonna go along with your free and half price items for hosting this cooking class tonight. And for the rest of you, if you would like to also duplicate this event and you find that you would like to learn a bit more about Epicure and our products, I would love to do the same for you and offer you not only a $20 voucher for your next cooking class, but you can also fill your pantry with free and half price items. I would normally have this set up, so we'll go from there. Linda Brown said to me at a cooking class event, take something shiny, the teapot shiny. So this girl brings along her wipes, because I figure if someone's gonna pay $69 for a pot, it's gonna look brand spanking new on my table. So this is what I do before the guests arrive.
Awesome.
So I just give that a little wipe. I always make sure my steamers are looking fairly clean and not water stained, because I find sometimes I have issues with that. With a dishwasher and hard water and Ingersoll, I'm going to be stepping in and out of my role. I will be actually telling you what I'm doing and thinking, and then I'll be moving back into as if I was in front of an actual class, okay? So just so you know what my agenda is for tonight. So, I think I'm pretty much ready to start. We're doing Mexican tonight, as I said, because I want to showcase our host special, our customer special. I want you to use your imagination. Epicure product sells itself. We all know that. Once you eat something, once you taste it, once you bring the spice out and pass the jar around, you already know what you're doing with that. You know your customers love that. But what I want you to focus on a little more tonight is, oh my goodness, there's a nice surprise.
Ah, yay!
It's Mr.
Surprise.
Craig.
This is your man.
I wasn't expecting that. Wow. Says, so told me he was in New York, little bugger. He's also my authorized assistant. He's in the back of my binder as a legal representative of this company as well. So we do share this business together, which makes it a lot of fun. All right. So we've thanked Epi. We've thanked the rest of the people that have come to the class. We've told them about the free product they're going to get and vouchers, and we're going to move on now. What I do next is I pass out the catalogs, and we do a very brief catalog tour. And before I start that, I'm going to go around the room, and I'm just going to ask everybody to introduce themselves and tell me a little about Epicure. So I'm going to pick a couple of people tonight just for that sort of thing. So where, why am I need a B?
Yes.
Do you want to introduce yourself to everybody? Because I do know you.
Okay. I'm Bea, and I've been with Epicure since October last year. Actually, I held my first Epicure class, October 1st. And Epicure has been great for me. I had just found out that my son was type 1 diabetic. So being Italian, had to change my whole way of cooking, no more fried, lots of veggies. And my cousin actually started selling Epicure and introduced me to it, and that's how I started it. And I ordered a few things from her, and my kids love it. I actually have my kids eating veggies, and they love it. And it all has to do with the taste of Epicure.
Excellent.
From the spices. So.
Excellent. Yeah. So what I would encourage you to do, seeing I love it when I get someone in the class who really knows Epicure and knows the product and can share what they, how it's changed their life, we have a contest starting. So if you like free stuff, $150 starting April 5th, you can put your story in for consideration and you just might walk away with that prize. So it would be really cool if you did that.
Yeah.
And Sam, I'm gone blank. Sandra.
Yeah.
Would you also introduce yourself, Erin?
My name is Sandra Dale. I've been an Epicure consultant for about 8 years. And I had an empty nest for a little while, so I needed something to do and some spare time, fill in some time. My son came back to live with me. He has a mental illness and an almost eating disorder. So Epicure helps him to try new foods and experiment that way. I have two other children too, and they love cooking now. My daughter didn't cook until she started cooking with Epicure, and she'll tell you she doesn't cook, and it's only because of Epicure that she cooks now. And she's on the Good Food Real Results plan and rocking it. She lives by herself, and she's prepping, and she's losing weight and feeling better.
What's your favorite product?
I like the knife. However, you know, I can buy the same thing at the dollar store.
Oh, well, thank you very, very much. So, I get that question a lot in my classes.
I was told to say that.
Yeah,
she's saying
my client's hands. So, this is our ceramic knife. This is the only one available to us as of May 1st. And I went to a cooking class one night looking for my knives, and they'd all disappeared because my children had taken them to do pumpkin carving because they work so perfectly. This knife is sharper than steel. It does not bruise any of your vegetables or your fruits because it doesn't oxidize. Metal oxidizes with the air, and that's why you get the rust. I have people in my dining club that will do pictures of kids with apples that they've taken to school. They come back with the odd piece left in their lunch pail, and it's still white. And I love when they post things like that. What I get a lot, stepping out of my role for a second, is, Kath, I can get it at the dollar store. Okay, you're getting coated ceramic. You're not getting solid ceramic. So if you hold our knives up, you can see through them. That will tell you that this is pure ceramic, and it is worth the money because it will cut better, it'll last longer. You're a coated ceramic or you're colored, and if you have that sort of issue with a customer, there's some answers for you. Do not cut as well. Okay. I actually learned that from someone at a cooking class who is not an Epicure consultant yet. Who had all kinds of stories for me. Okay, so that's one of my biggest blocks I get is, I can go and get this elsewhere. Okay, well, let me explain to you the benefits of why you need to use this particular one over something else. All right. So I go around the room, I talk to everybody, I get a good feel. I always get, no matter who in a room I get someone who's never heard of it, or they got dragged in. So it leads you right into be able to say, look, we're only in 12% of the population right now. So anybody who's thinking maybe, they know that we're not so saturated, and if someone says, oh, there's so many Epicure reps right now, well, there really isn't. Not if we're only in 12% of the population. So that's usually a nice lead in to throw that one out there. So the next thing we're gonna do, everyone has their catalog. I was very iffy about this. You suggested I do this when you, no pressure there. One day she calls me at 11 o'clock in the morning, oh, I'm coming to your class tonight, Kath. And I go, But it was great, because of course there was a baby there, so give her the baby, and she was preoccupied for the rest of the day.
You did a fabulous job.
Thank you. she suggested that I do this catalog tour, and then at product launch, we also had an opportunity to do that. And I then did it for a lot of my groups, and I would have repeat customers, and I'd say, okay, I want your feedback afterwards. Like, what do you think? And everybody loved it, so now I do it. So was it Linda Brown that did the tour with us last time?
Yeah, she did.
Yeah, it really works. Yeah. And then I had the great pleasure of being a guest at Denise's cooking class about 3 weeks ago. And she introduced this little trick to me. So I went around the room. I really like going around the room. It gives me an idea of who we've got, what they know, who's going to want me to tell them what and what they need me to talk more about. So I think it's really worth that little 5 minutes, right? And then what Denise did. So she then said, I'd like to introduce you to Sylvia Roche and Amelia Warren. So that's where I start my catalog tour. They open it up, I will tell you that they're a Canadian company, mother-daughter team. Sylvia used to go to the local fairs with her spice jars, and if she did a $250 day, she was really excited. Really, really excited. And I will tell you, and I tell everyone in my classes, she is the most genuine woman you'll ever meet. Both of them are. It would be just like she was sitting right there, and suddenly I introduced them as the owner and CEO of the company. You just have to meet them. You have to make the time to come to conference. You have to make the time to come to anything that they're doing, because once you meet them, the sincerity is there that you then understand why you're doing what you're doing. So I usually say that right in the class. And then I don't get too much with this, because everybody's different. If somebody has already talked to me and said, well, we're in the introduction, I'm really interested in learning about good food or results, then I will probably stay on this a little bit longer. I have this prepared. I also have my good food real results to just to key places. So people that need the guidance and need the help and need the background, this is a good tool for them in prep, how they're gonna set their kitchen up, how they're gonna shop, how they're gonna plan and actual menus. And I just briefly go through a few of the pages. I have them marked just to show them what they're gonna get for this. It's an excellent, Mother Beaton used to do in the 1800s. You see this great huge book on how to run your household. Well, this is a really slick modern day. This is how you're gonna prep. And then I just have about four pages. And I really like to focus on this page that came from Ling Tam. This page here gives you substitutions. So if you're going through this book with somebody, it's a really great place to show them how they can sub in whatever proteins they prefer, whether they're vegan, whether they're red meat eaters or seafood, and the different grains they can use. So this is a really good page to showcase as well. And then for the people that are not savvy, of course I chose the Mexican recipes because that's what we're focusing on today. You also have recipes in here. And that's about as brief as I do with this. I say it's an absolute program that you can follow that takes all the guesswork out of everything. And if you're looking for that kind of stability and that kind of support, we do have the good food real results. And if it's a group that have had too many margaritas and they just want to get on to the actual let's get cooking, I don't spend as much time on that as well. I spend a fair bit of time on the superfoods, talking about the fiber that's in them, the turmeric, the anti-inflammatories. I talk a bit about the teas because I think they're really important. I know Kate and I were British upbringing, tea and milk. And we had the Sleeping Beauty tea, we had a sample, and we were like waiting for the shipment to arrive because it really does relax you. Mm-hmm. And you really wake up in the morning feeling great. So I give a lot of samples of my tea out, because once someone's had a couple of cups of tea, they're buying the box. And then what I also think is really, really important here is how this catalog does the collections. It takes all the guesswork for people. If they're trying to put together a specific thing that we've made, they can just look at the collections, buy the collections, start there, add a few spices, and I find it a really good tool. So I make a point of pointing those out. And then what's really nice is right behind this is the index. So at the end of the class, if you need to look for some extra assistance finding things we've talked about in the catalog. And that's about as much as I'm going to talk about with the catalog. Some people bring uprights with the host specials. I have them in my book. I can either hold the book up or I can put them in the put them in the uprights. I do either or. So what we are going to do now is, everybody's going to wash their hands. So everybody's gone, everybody's come back. Now we're gonna do the cooking portion. When the cooking portion is over, I'm gonna do a bit of a wrap up. And I'm a very unorthodox person, so you need to know, back in my role as consultant standing in front of you, I will do little things all through it. So there'll be infomercials. So every once in a while, my timer will go off and it'll be ding, 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 and I'm gonna give you a little tidbit of something, okay? So we'll stop, we'll do the little 2-minute infomercial, we'll go back to the cooking, and then once the cooking's over, we'll wrap up, and then we'll sit, you can sit and eat everything and come and see me and we'll have a chat. And how's that sound to you? Okay, ready to get cooking? That's what you really came for, didn't you?
Yep.
Yeah, of course. Of course. That's why my husband showed up.
She didn't bring food though, Craig.
Every Mexican class, I do a guacamole, I do a salsa, and I do a fruit salsa. Lately, I have added to it queso. What we do is, I usually ask for the avocados to be pre-done, and then we will make the guacamole, and I get the old, make sure you use this. Now, can someone, free draws tonight, free tickets, free prizes. Can somebody tell me the correct way to use this? Does anybody know? How do you put the lemon in this?
Upside down.
And why is that?
Because it flips the whole unit and takes out all the juice.
And it doesn't squirt all over the place. You ever had it go in your face? I had this upside down so many times, and I would go to squirt it and be in my face and all over my desk, and I'd be so embarrassed. And one nice person, by shadowing a class, I went to see someone else's class, showed me how to use this correctly. It really makes a big difference, putting just a little squeeze of lime in each one of these when you're making them. Why take the time to do it? Well, you just might sell one of these, and your guacamole and your salsa is going to taste that little bit better. So what I do is, I have these set up in stations. I do a straight salsa with the pico and the tomatoes, and then I do tomatoes and a fruit, and let the host pick. So whether it's mango, pineapple, peach, and then I use the poco with the poco, the pico. I use the hot one.
Picante.
I use that one just to give a little bite, because you've got the sweet and you've got the heat together, and it goes really nicely. So that's a standard that I do. The guacamole is just a straight, like I said, we actually cut, because I want people to see the knife works on any particular thing. I want them to see how it can cut through bread, can cut through chicken, can cut through a tomato by rinsing it off and not needing to have a whole sink full of knives afterwards. Because my biggest thing with everybody is, everything is multifunctional. You do not need a cupboard full of gadgets. Everything I show you tonight will serve 3 or 4 purposes. And that's why I find it so easy to use this product. So this is what we make, or these. Then I take a jar of queso, because I can't find those big jars of cheese anymore. I think Costco used to have them. So queso is like just like a cheese sauce. You know, if you ever go to the movies and they've got the cheese sauce they put on the tortillas.
Okay.
You used to be able to buy a big jar of it, and I'd still be looking for it and then freeze it in my freezer. So it's pretty bland, actually, guys. So we bring out the nacho and the cheese and jalapeno, and we add that to this queso and put it in the microwave and heat it up, and it's a nice little extra treat. Because what's been happening while this is going on is, we're making our own corn tortilla chips. So simple. I have a really good friend in the back row who brings me huge things of corn tortillas for $1.80. $1.80 makes approximately 4 to 5 bags of regular corn chips. $1.80, guys. So you cut them, we have them cut them, I have them line them up on the crisper, because I sell crispers to every guest when we do this little piece. We line them up on here, and I can tell you what I really like about making my own corn tortilla chips is, I can brush them with water, so that the salt or the chili stencil, I will introduce the chili stencil, because we have people that are having kidney issues or high blood pressure and need to worry about the salt intake, or our wonderful grinder. Ah, ticket time. What's unique about our grinders? Can anybody tell me?
The grinds are different ways.
You can adjust the grinds in the top. So many people don't know that.
And it's ceramic.
And it's ceramic also, right. Line them all up. There's two ways of doing this. Sometimes I just line them all up, throw them in the oven, 350, 7 minutes. And then I brush them afterwards. I just toss them in a container and I just take the my little brush here and I just brush them afterwards and grind the stuff on a stick. For people that are watching their diet, they want water, you can spritz it with water and then your salt or your sense will stick to that. So I'm making tortilla chips. They're nice and warm, they're quick, they're crispy. I'm showing how it browns on both sides, not just telling people, oh, this really works, guys. I'm actually doing it. And I'm doing two or three piles, I usually take two. And then at that time, I let them all sample what's going on. And they get to try the dips and everything. Because infomercial time, so we're condensing this really quickly. This probably takes about 10 minutes in total to do. And then while they're chatting, most of them are drinking tequilas by this time. The class goes really differently. You had that happen once, sombrero and all. In fact, we had a sales and marketing director get online today with a sombrero on her head. Right. So I'd like to talk to you about, while you're all eating, I said infomercial time, so you've all chatted. I let my guests actually have a bit of fun. I let them start all chatting and drinking and eating. And that's why I say I'm going to do an infomercial time. So they know when I say I've got an infomercial, they all stop talking and let me say it, because otherwise I lose control pretty fast. Right? So if they know it's coming, I've explained it to them, it's going to happen, that's what happens. So I'd like to show you our kits. Everybody familiar with the Go Fresh and the kits that come to your door complete with your meat, your vegetables, your spices, all in one box? Okay. Great concept. But what I love about what Epicure has done is that they have combined all the spices, and most importantly for the people who aren't recipe savvy, recipes to give you variation alternatives. And there's enough in our boxes for 40 plates. Now, I am very conscious, I grow my own vegetables, and I'm very conscious of where I'm getting my meat and where I'm getting my vegetables. So I like the flexibility and the control of being able to use this alternative kit as opposed to that solution. And I also am on a budget as well, and I like to take advantage of store sales, so when meat's on special. So this is the perfect solution. We have currently 8 choices, different themes: Thai, Indian, Mexican, Greek, Italian. And if you were to purchase all 8, you have enough for the entire month. No guesswork. You'll know what you'll be making every single month, every day. Just pick something from these boxes. What I like about this is you're looking at about $3.50 per serving per plate, as opposed to the box brands are more like $13.50. A little more pricey if you're going to put shrimp in your pad thai as opposed to chickpeas. So I really recommend these kits. And if you are just starting out, you want something just so you have a complete package, this is, I think, the way to go. All right, back to eating. You enjoying the food? How's that queso taste?
Delicious.
A little better than what it normally does? What do you think of the fruit and the salsa?
Yummy. So good.
Got a little bite to it?
Delicious.
As I had someone on Wednesday night, Roxy's decided to join me, so I always check that out too. I had someone run to the kitchen to get a tablespoon of peanut butter because it was a little hot, and apparently that was the fastest way to cool them down. So there's a little trick for you too, and it worked. So what I did not tell you as I was talking about this, I was doing a little something in the background. At the very beginning of the class, I fell upon it, and now I'm doing it every day in every class. Summer's coming up, and not all of us have central air, and our kitchens are getting hot. And if you're in a trailer, it's warm. And again, if you're on vacation in a trailer, you don't want to spend hours at your kitchen preparing meals. So I'm a keen advocate of our steamers and the usages. When I'm doing the burger ones, what I like to do is put bacon, layer it in, put it in the microwave, push a button, go on with the class, and the kitchen isn't smeeching up with bacon. No one's having to stand over the stove and turn it. And at the end of the class, when I'm putting all the food together, We go, we pull this out, and the bacon's already done. It acts like a George Foreman, all the fat's in the bottom. I take the sprayer, spray off the trays, and everybody goes, ooh and ah. But there's also another. This, of course, Epicure gives us all kinds of choices. Maybe you don't have the multi-purpose steamer yet. So you can also use our bacon roll. And we can put the bacon on this, put it in the oven, forget about it. Beauty of our liners are, is that my pan, I've done 147 classes, and these pans look pretty good still. I've gone through a couple different bacon rolls, I'll be honest with you there, because I use them so often that I've found I've replaced them all throughout the year. But I've always had two or three anyway, because when you're doing savory, and then I do my cookies, I like to have two liners for my pan. So this is another option. The grease doesn't fall out, doesn't go into your pan. You're not stuck afterwards using a scouring pad trying to get all that burnt on stuff. You simply put this under the sprayer and it all washes off. So that's another alternative to standing over a frying pan. And I know during a cooking class I couldn't do that. So, what I did at the very beginning of the class is we put cup and a half of rice in here, some water. We put in some beans. I like black beans. I also like Farm Boy has these beautiful mixed beans. The more I'm venturing into vegan classes, the more I'm starting to really enjoy vegan food. So I really like the legumes. And so I throw the rice, I throw the beans in, water, diced tomatoes, half a can, and half a package of cha-cha chili. And I get the most incredible Spanish rice that's going to go with what we're making here, because I'm creating an entire meal from this. And we've made it, and I've thrown it in the microwave, and it's working its magic while I'm doing the class. And then all of a sudden, this is going to come out perfectly cooked. And then when it comes out, people can see. You ever tried to clean a pan when you've done rice in? You have to stand over the rice, right? You got to sit there with a scouring pad, let it soak overnight. This stuff just slides right out. And it's cooked to perfection. So, everybody buys a steamer in my classes. Everybody buys a crisper. Everybody buys a bacon roll. Everybody buys a knife. Because they came for the guacamole. That's what they came for. They were going to buy guacamole. All right. So while that's been going on, I already had my chicken pre-cut. I hate cutting chicken, even though the knife works on chicken. And I talk to people about how the ceramic knife might chip or if it's too frozen. So it's really nice when it's just at that sort of almost defrosted stage. Great, I cut the chicken ahead of time because I don't want to cross contaminate. And you know, it's just too messy, right? So the chicken's in a nice bowl. Well, you tell them, well, you know what? If you only have fajita, let's use that. You only have taco, let's use that. You got nacho cheese, you have salsa. Depending on what's in your cupboard, you can use any one of those spices because I like to show that any spice can be used for exactly what you don't think it's for. Because maybe you don't have something else. You know that I have to go to the store for that one more thing? That's what I like about Epicure. There's never that one more thing. You always get something to pick from, something to use. So we make the chicken. If I'm using the steamer, we might have showcased the griddle. I might have put it on the bacon roll, and I might have put it in a frying pan. It's totally up to you. I think I've done a fair number of things to show you tonight, so I probably would have used the griddle tonight and then done up some peppers. That will take approximately 5 minutes. So this is already in the microwave. You have to walk away from it.
Do you leave that in the microwave?
Well, I do a fairly large batch because I'm hoping to get 10 to 15 people every class. Jody's a guru at that.
Just ask her. Yeah, you're making this look like I should be taking notes. This is fantastic. But like 15-ish minutes, would you say?
A large amount of rice,
yeah.
Just like on the directions. I actually put it on for 18.
Okay.
And then I always make a point of going to check it when I'm checking. Always put someone in charge of the oven. Because I burned quite a few of these guys. So I put someone in charge of the 7-minute timer. And then when I go out to kind of just take a break while they're all talking away, then I will just check that rice has actually worked. Because everybody's microwave isn't got the same wattage.
And just once all the juices are starting to absorb.
Oh man,
soft.
I can't even tell you how good this is.
Good.
Craig.
Just
I came home from a cooking class. Craig works a lot of late hours, and I got home. I was absolutely exhausted. I had two grandchildren all day. Did a cooking class. It was 9 o'clock when I got home, and he's on his way home, and I was able to throw that with some ground beef together. I put it in the microwave, so I thought, dang, just learned this one. So I threw it, the other half can of my diced tomatoes and the other half package of my cha-cha chili, and I threw it in and pushed a button and then went on and did what I had to do, and when he got home, he had dinner made, so it was kind of neat. So that brought already 20.
And we ran out.
Yeah. So you could put chicken in this, you could put, I like the beans. Like I like a good steak, guys. But I'm going to start experimenting with buying them from the bulk store and letting them soak overnight. I mean, Craig's mom used to do that all the time. I might. But for the average person, this is what I say. I get my can opener out. I always get my can opener out in a class and I say, we all know, because I get different age groups, we all know that if you put soup bones and you boil them down, you get your soup broth. We all know, and I'm pretty sure everybody in this room knows how to do something from scratch, or they've watched their mothers or grandmothers do it. If I can get someone to put the can opener, I hold it in my hand, and I open the drawer to put the can opener back, and move one step forward using the broths, using other things, then that's what I think is my starting point, is getting someone to put that away. Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. So I do that as well. So we've got the rice going, we've made chips, everybody's eating all these different things, and I've just shown them how they can throw, like I put the nacho cheese around, and then everybody goes, oh, well, if I'm out of taco, I just use the nacho cheese, because it smells pretty much the same, guys. So if you're out, you don't have to go, oh my God, I gotta find someone, someone got that in stock. No, just use something else. You know, but show them what you're using, because then if they go home and try and duplicate it and it doesn't taste the same, they're gonna wonder why. So don't sneak it into a jar and pretend it was something else. That backfired on me once, because I did it, guys. And they said, this doesn't taste like that. And I was like, oh, dang. I was faking it then, just like I am now. Okay, so at this point in time, there's all kinds of ways you guys can go. And I will tell my guests, there's all kinds of ways we can go with all these things we just created, because you really want to do another class, don't you? Because we, unfortunately, you really wanted nachos, and I didn't tell you all about how nachos would be great. We've got our chips, we've got our chicken, we've got our guac, we've got all our salsas. We're going to put it on here. You don't need parchment, don't need tinfoil anymore, guys. It just slides right off the tray. You know, you lose all your cheese? Not anymore if you use this. Bee's going, damn, we're not making that tonight. I really like nachos. Well, let's do one, Bee, because I can do 6 or 7 different Mexican. Did you know that your friend's having one 3 weeks from now?
Yeah.
You gotta come. We're gonna do it again. We'll do more. I'll show you more ideas. Okay. So I've got my tortilla chip here. We can either do quesadillas, and I can throw them on the crisper, put them in a fry pan, put them here, or you can just do some wraps. And I'm just gonna let you guys go. The shredded cheese, do that ahead of time, guys. Get that done. I send out a list to all my hosts. I have my menu, what I'm bringing, what they're gonna bring. And I have specific instructions. Cut the chicken ahead of time. Cut the cheese. Shred the cheese ahead of time. Because you don't wanna waste your time. Now, we used to have a nice little thingy. So we're definitely, if you know, whatever happens down the road, showcase what you have. Do not bring your 5-inch knife unless you don't have a small knife, because someone's going to go, I want that, and you're going to say, oh, I'm sorry, it's in the vault. The peeler, I'm so disappointed with the peeler. We always just brought a carrot out for the hell of bringing a carrot out, even when we weren't using carrots, just because someone would do that and go, oh, that's on my list, right? So there you go. So thank you very much. What else have we got here? I have one last little game for you to think about. Now we've all been, you know, we're all getting familiar and cozy with each other. I've made a few friends tonight, that's kind of cool. I'd like you to write down on a piece of paper two people in this group that you think could really do this, that might really enjoy this, or you could see doing it. Okay, so I want you to do that. So I've handed you all pieces of paper. You've got draw tickets for your participation. I might have thrown a few more infomercials out there. stepping back out of my role again. Sorry, it's confusing. I'm not an actor. We do have one in the room, but it's not me.
Dun, dun, dun.
Usually when all else fails, I do something really foolish, right? That's about all you can do. Or I'll fire myself in front of everybody, because guess what, guys, you can. I do fire myself quite often, don't I, Craig?
Yep.
I get really mad at myself, and I go, that's it, I'm done. And then I go, silly girl, you love what you do, because I do. All right. So everybody's done that. Why have we all done that? Checkout. What am I going to do at checkout with all these names? I probably have a pretty good idea who I'm going to talk to, going to, terrible grammar, going to speak to. But maybe I've missed something. And maybe somebody in that room noticed something I didn't. So I now have pieces of paper with people's names on to do something with after that class. Now, what we did not do is Epi and I had a pretty good conversation about half an hour before class started. We were talking about the business, and I mean, she and I have been friends for about 2 years, right? So we were talking about how fun this is, and she's had about four classes with me personally. Yes, four? Yeah, I've had four in the house. We've had four personal classes, and I really think she'd be really good at this. So I've already talked to her about all this ahead of time. And during the class tonight, while I've been running out and checking the stove and that, I've actually let her take over and talk about everything. I actually did that with one person, didn't I, Lynn? Yeah. And she did a great job, didn't you? You're just back and forth talking to people about what you knew, and it was great fun. So at the end of the class, I've now got names, and I'm just going to do my little wrap-up. So I'm going to step back into my consultant role again. Are you schizophrenic yet? Because I'm made of a little back and forth. Anyway, so then I get out the catalog and the order form. I will have done one infomercial that I have not done. This is where basically I would like to let you know that I really enjoy what I'm doing. And is there anybody out there who could use an extra $400 a month? And if you had an extra $400 a month, but I told you you could not use it on the utility, what would you do with it? Anybody want to share? Travel. Would you? Some places you'd like to see and do? Cool.
Alaska.
Yeah.
Cold places.
I'm weird.
No. Weird is great. Weird is great. Anybody else want to share? That's what I love about Epicure's flexibility as well. So if you have, the average cooking class is about $100, what you will make in commission. That's the average. Some people are rocking their business and can do much more to class or less. So if you just did four cooking classes a month, one a week, beauty of the business, flexibility. So you can pick the nights you want to work. You might want to do them during the day. You might be doing breakfast if you work shift work. What would you do with $400? I know I'm putting it to good use. And I really love the flexibility. Now, most of us joined for the discount, right? I know I did. Shannon, I'm never going to do anything more than buy it for my nieces that are getting married and my children. And I really want the product, and I really like the discount. But what other company pays for all your free gifts up front? You get to go out every night and offer free product to someone. You get to work with them, you get to know them, and then they bring you more friends, and you get to offer free product to them as well. Epicure covers the costs up front. I love my job. Do you know how many hosts post in my dining club? It's Christmas. It's fun, a lot of stuff comes in the house, isn't it, Kate? Mm-hmm. I have not been bought yet. They still do not know what's in the new catalog, but that's another whole story, guys. I'm gonna let someone else share that with you. Holy cow. I'm so excited what I'm gonna be able to do with my cooking classes with that. But for now, I'm gonna focus on Cinco de Mayo and our specials for April. So I usually close a little bit about the business, as you just heard, and why I think it's so great. And yeah, I'm a very shy person. I am brave, but I like it. I like the recognition. I like when I hear my name. I like when I see my name. I like still being part of Team McLean. I'll always, my first love will be Team McLean. even though Team Rathrum's pretty cool. Pretty cool. And then I check out. And I make sure I point out on the order form those questions. I want people thinking about it. Interest in hosting, interest in fundraising. Sometimes I use the draw tickets that are back in my book. I always have everything with my fingertips. So I may have passed these draw tickets. I may have passed these, what are they?
The little questionnaires.
I may have passed them out ahead of time. I might have used those for what I want you to put on your back, the back, who you think would be good at this. And then I will have pointed out at this point in time, I've already talked about the specials, but I do have them. I do have the visuals to show people. Sometimes I put them in an upright. Sometimes I just have them sitting on a coffee table. Love putting stuff out for people to look at. They really like it. And then, of course, what's really new right now is our new vault list. Making sure that your customers get their product that's being discontinued. That's one of my priorities this week. So I have that handy. And then I make sure I go somewhere fairly private. Somewhere a little out of the way of everybody carrying on to do my checkout, because that's when I can get a one-on-one with everybody, get a bit more information out of them, let them know a little bit more about me, upsell them a bit. Mm-hmm. Always look at their list and say, Christy Friend. It's funny, when I'm doing a class, I really am schizophrenic, because I hear everybody who I've ever shadowed and every training I've ever done, and I hear them saying, do this and it'll happen. And it's like, yeah, it really does. So I always say great choices. I always find something really good that's on that list to talk about with them. Put them at ease. It's an icebreaker, right? And then I talk through, and you would not believe the number of people that are like, oh, I can't do a cooking class. I don't have any friends. I said, me too. I said, that's how I'm making friends. And you wouldn't believe how, in a course conversation, they can go from, I don't have any friends, to, it was your aunt, wasn't it? Your aunt. I don't have any friends, to, well, I really could use that, to, okay. I usually got 50% of whoever attends will rebook, usually. And that really helps me, because I really need to know going into the next month I'm covered, because I'm always, what I always say to you guys, I need one more. Good old Kathy Straw came to the plate today, yes. but I used to sweat, like I used to go, oh my gosh, these people said they'd do a cooking class and they put me off. And I go, oh, I really needed them. But then soon June comes, and they're there and they're booked, and it's like, oh, I've already got five for this month before I even pick the phone up. It's like, sorry.
Are you finding it to repeat? Like, I'm nervous of expiring the same crowd. Like, are you finding it to repeat customers?
No.
They're like, it's branching away from original and then going from there.
I'm finding.
Like, are you having repeat hostesses?
I do have
you
repeat.
Do?
Most of my repeat hostesses are now my part of my team.
Okay, gotcha.
Or they're going to be my testimonials. And plus, with my new team, I've given a lot of my customers up, because I feel it's really important that we have such an intermix of people.
Yeah.
That, for instance, we sit down, and I use these two here. I'll sat down with them and I said, we're doing the cooking class. These are your and your spouse's friends going forward.
Yeah.
There's a couple that will be, we've got one poor little girl, Ashley Johnson. She's friends with about four of my consultants, and she buys from everybody.
Wow.
And you know, and she, but she likes the product enough, she will do, you know, good for $100 over here, $100 there.
Yeah.
I don't think I could survive on the old. My friends and family, they're worn down. They wore down month three.
Yeah.
They're hard to get. But your friends and family will get you the next one, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's, can I interrupt?
Yes, go ahead.
So
I'm done. I'll take over.
Give her a big round.